Psalms 34 verse 4 states, "Delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart." The scriptures have made us aware that our dreams and goals can be achieved as promised by God. When we start executing our plans to attain these goals and dreams, often we are motivated, excited, and happy as things are sailing smoothly and making great progress. In the midst of it all, a storm ascends. The storms and trials we are not anticipating. Because if the truth be told, we don't know what the future holds and what we'll have to deal with. A sudden illness, a breakup with a partner, the loss of a job or a contract. It is easier to feel disheartened and hopelessness. But let me remind you, God is not a man that he should lie. Numbers 23:19. God does not make promises that he will not fulfill. God does not put a dream in our hearts and not make a way for us to achieve it. We may not see a way to achieve our dreams, but remember Mark 9:23 tells us that all things are possible for one who believes. God's ways are not our ways. We think naturally, but God is supernatural. God has answers to our problems that we could never think of. God would have never allowed us to encounter those storms if they were going to keep us from reaching our destiny and purpose. We may question God and ask why he has allowed storms in our lives to be so severe to the point where we lose faith and hope. But I want you to remember that it is all part of the process. The good news is God is in control of the winds, the waves, and the storm. He is in control of what's trying to stop you from reaching your dreams, purpose, and destiny. God only has to shift the winds, and instead of holding you back, they will push you forward. The storms were meant for your harm, but God will turn them into your advantage. God is still saying you will get there. God is still on the throne. God is fighting your battles behind the scenes. He is assembling the right people. What God has promised you, it will still come to pass. Your health is going to get well. You will break that addiction. You will win that contract. And you will still achieve those dreams. Now I have a question for you. Will you trust God when you do not see any signs of things improving? Will you stay in faith when you are hearing those small voices in your head telling you that it is never going to work out? I want you to remember this. You cannot be moved by what you see. You have to be moved by what you know. And what you know is the Word of God. Do not let the storm make you lose faith in what God has promised.